So here we are at our working microgrid, and this is actually, you know, it looks like a mock-up with all this equipment, but it's actually a fully functioning microgrid. So we're going to talk about how energy storage plays a role in this microgrid application. The cool thing about this, as you can see, is we have the utility source, a generator source, an energy storage source, which is batteries, the solar, which is outside in the parking lot you saw on the way in, and then we also have a new one that we're adding right now, which is supercapacitors. I'm going to talk a little bit about each one, and I'm going to talk about how the energy storage part plays into all of this. So basically, right now we have 18 kilowatts of power. 12 is coming from the utility, 5 is coming from the solar, and we have certain states of charge that we try to maintain on the batteries and certain requirements from the utility. So from a load leveling standpoint, we can look like a nice flat line from the utility standpoint, which is great. We have targets that we try to maintain, which would be like 10 or 12 kilowatts or 15 kilowatts to maintain for our load so that utility sees a nice constant power. How do we use energy storage to do that? Let's take a look at another graphic here. This is actually, you know, unfortunately, today we only had about 5 kilowatts of solar because we're in Pittsburgh, as you probably know, right? So we don't have a lot of sun, but we get some every once in a while. But anyway, this is a nice sunny day. You see the green line here is where solar goes up and is kind of your typical parabolic shape, right? Now, what we're trying to do is maintain our energy storage level and the utility level at a flat rate. So basically what you see is our load is the red line. And as you see the ups and downs in that, that's basically our HVAC, our air conditioning cycling. And what's interesting about this is during the day, the yellow line, or what we draw from the utility, is actually zero. So during that day where we had enough solar, the energy storage was kicking in, which was the blue line, and we're actually able to maintain a nice flat line for our utility draw. Now, during the middle of the day, the batteries were full. So we got to that top end state of charge, and basically we put some of the power back into the grid, so we had a low level of 5 kilowatts that we put back into the grid. And then what's really interesting about this is if you see overnight, 10 o'clock at night, what's going on here? What's going on there is actually the blue line, or the energy storage, goes negative. We charge the batteries. So overnight we're gonna charge the batteries when the power's cheap, and we draw a little bit more from the utility. Then during the day we do that load leveling piece. So it's really a nice complement to the microgrid system. Now, transitioning into what are we going to do with these guys, okay? So we'll look at supercapacitors versus lithium ion batteries. This is a 30 kilowatt hour stack of lithium ion batteries. So 30 kilowatts for an hour, 60 kilowatts for an hour, that kind of thing. If we go back to sort of energy storage, traditional energy storage, we look at lead acid batteries and other types of storage. You know, you look at UPS applications, you might get 500 to 800, maybe deep discharges. In this case, you know, lithium ion batteries, we're getting tens of thousands, 10 or 20,000 deep discharges. So why would we consider something supercap? Supercaps go to maybe 1 million operations. So we're doing on, off, on, off, on, off. But what's the difference between these two? What the difference is that guy can take 10 or 20,000 hits, but it can last a long time. This one can take 1 million operations, but it's only for maybe a few seconds or maybe a half a minute. Now, if I can run for 20 seconds, if I go back to my other graphic here, I have that generator sitting there. That generator can actually come up to speed in about 10 seconds. So I can go through short duration events with supercaps. And now I'm not hitting my batteries, and I'll leave those guys for the long-term thing. So it's a really nice hybrid system. So one of the really important things that you look on this screen and you see is, again, on that example screen that I showed you, we had a nice smooth day. We had good solar all day long. Today, we don't have that. We have this jaggedy kind of green line. Where does energy storage come in? The blue line shows that response to that jaggedy storage, which is basically, we're gonna take some of the energy storage, like right now, we're actually charging the batteries because we have a lot of solar. But in another situation, we would actually discharge the batteries because the solar goes behind a cloud. It's a really great concept, and it's a really good way to use a microgrid as a system to optimize your storage. And especially comes into play with those lithium ion batteries because you can do a lot of operations, and especially with the supercaps that can do those short term, you know, just behind a cloud and back, just behind a cloud and back. And this is why coming to a place like Eaton's Power Systems Experience Center, you can see all this stuff live. And not having just a mock-up or an emulator, this is the full thing. Now over here, we actually have the controller, and that's really the brains behind all of it. If we use that controller to monitor what's going on and kind of put in the customer's information of what they want to do to optimize, you want to optimize either around one of two things with a microgrid: resiliency or reliability, or efficiency. So if I'm a university campus, I'm looking at efficiency. If I'm a military base, I want to make sure I get the power to stay on, right? So that's what that optimizer does, and we have lots of controls in here that are 80% by us. People want to have those already predefined, and then you have a lot of, you know, tweaking that you can do. And in fact, you could do more, you know, tweaking if you want on larger systems. So now what would happen, this is a basically a 50 kilowatt system. We have, you know, the super caps, we have the inverters here with the energy storage, and it's all tied together with a motor control center over here. All that on off control, it's a 50 kilowatt system roughly. What if I wanted to go to a 5 megawatt system, a large system? What would I change? The control, the inverters would be bigger. Of course, my solar outside would be bigger. My batteries would be bigger. All of the components would be bigger, and instead of having a motor control center, I would use switchgear. So this is where having a system like this, running through the tweaks of all the settings and doing some really cool stuff here, we get to play with electricity. What could be better than that, right? So when you get a chance later on down the road, we're going to encourage you to try to come here as part of a tour for yourselves and see this stuff in person. But this is our microgrid at the Power Systems Experience Center.